Bank Prize in Economics for Nobel 2008 is awarded to Professor Paul Krugman.
이분의 성함을 소개하게 되는 날이 올 것이라고는 상상을 하지 못했었는데요. 세계 경제지리학 연구의 최고 권위자이자 2008년 노벨상 수상자이신 와우. 세계적인 경제학자 폴 크루그먼 교수님이 온라인으로 연결돼 있습니다.
아, 아니 대박인데?
Professor Krugman, are you there?
Oh, hi.
First of all, thank you so much for taking your time to have this chat with us today. I hope you're safe and well out there in New York.
The North Atlantic region, we're seeing explosive growth. Over the past month in the United States, new infections have grown at an average of about 3% a day. We're facing a very dark winter.
그 교수님 말씀 들어보니까 엎친 데 더 충격으로 이제 겨울까지 와서 올해 겨울은 정말 길고도 추울 것 같습니다.
그러면은 일단은 세계 경제가 언제쯤 완벽히 회복이 될까요?
And let me say that I'm of the belief that once there is a vaccine and once people are less concerned about infection, we will actually see quite rapid economic recovery. This is very different from the slump that followed the financial crisis. That slump left an overhang of high levels of household debt. It left an overhang of excess construction. Basically, there were large private sector imbalances, and it took years to work those off. This is not like that. This is where we were abruptly hit by a headwind from the coronavirus, and were forced to lock down our economies to deal with that. But once that headwind is eliminated, there's every reason to expect a very rapid recovery.
백신이 개발되면 경제가 회복될 수 있을 거라고 말씀을 해주셨는데. 사실 한국에는 K-방역뿐만이 아니라 이게 K-바이오도 있거든요. 네. 한국은 이 코로나 충격을 줄이고 다른 분야에서도 좀 앞서갈 수 있지 않을까.
작지만 강한 나라.
예.
Professor Krugman, what's your outlook on the Korean economy post-COVID-19?
What Korea needs to do is align itself with the powers that are trying to restore and sustain the international system. That your interests lie in being part of a coalition of nations for a rules-based open world trading system. So I think Korea needs to, in a way, stand up and say, okay, we are part of the solution. And Korea has some clout, some reputational clout because of its extraordinary success in controlling the coronavirus.
최근에 뉴스에서 막 백신 전쟁이라는 단어까지 쓰더라고요. 벌써 막 부자 나라들이 백신을 다 차지했다 이런 얘기도 있고 이런 전쟁이라는 워딩을 쓰니까 되게 걱정스럽더라고요, 상황이.
If only because, not just because of some sense of social justice, though I like to hope there's some of that, but because I think everyone who has any understanding of this realizes that the vaccine offers some protection, but a lot of protection if we believe Pfizer, but still, it's also critically important to vaccinate enough of the population that you really reach herd immunity, that you really, that you break the chain of transmission by having enough people vaccinated. Poorer countries, will the pharmaceuticals be made available to them cheaply enough? Will they have the administrative capacity? What we're hearing about this Pfizer vaccine is that it's not actually as simple as one might have hoped. It's not that you simply get a shot and that's it. A wealthy country can do and can easily organize. Developing countries, maybe not. And so if it's actually the case that we have the vaccine works the way we think it is, You do wonder whether this, whether COVID-19 will be endemic in poorer parts of the world, even as rich countries are able to finally move on from it. This is a case where we really should have a global commitment, but also just as a matter of basic justice. I would like to think that we will see some kind of global agreement.
Thank you very much, Professor Krugman, for offering us so much precious insight.
Same to you.